You are all familiar with James Hansen. He is the NASA Institute for Space Studies at the Goddard Space Flight Center scientist who said about tar sands. He's been warning about climate change for quite some time. Said about tar sands that it is game over for climate change if that reserve is tapped. The amount of CO2 that will go into the atmosphere will be irreversible. And the greenhouse effects of that will essentially mean that climate change is a done deal. I should also mention Robert Goddard, the guy who invented the rocket from Worcester, Massachusetts. I'm paid by the Worcester Chamber of Commerce just to mention that every time his name comes up. So fizz.org is sent to us by longtime listener Eric. Fizz.org reports that two scientists who apparently were working on a separate project, Van Oldenborgh and Haarsma, they got sick and they decided essentially to, these are two researchers at the Royal Netherlands Meteorological Institute. They were taking a break from research because they were sick or due to someone's illness. And so they got to look back through some older publications and they came across a paper published in the Journal of Science in August 1981, written by a team of atmospheric physicists led by James Hansen. It was 10 pages in Science, and it covered a lot of advanced topics related to climate, indicating the level of knowledge known about climate science even at that time. The paper essentially outlined predictions as to the rate of growth of CO2 in the atmosphere, both naturally occurring and man-made, projected a future rise based upon continued use of fossil fuels by humans. These two scientists from the Netherlands, Van Oldenborgh and Haarsma, overlaid data gathered by NASA and their outfit in the Netherlands and found that the projections made by Hansen and his team were basically spot on. This is now 32, 31 years ago. Hansen wrote in the original paper, it is shown that the anthropogenic carbon dioxide warming should emerge from the noise level of natural climate variability by the end of the century. In other words, man-made carbon dioxide warming, man-made global warming, will statistically be able to be picked out from natural climate variability by the end of the century. In other words, year 2000 or so. And there is a high probability of warming in the 1980s. Potential effects on climate in the 21st century include the creation of drought-prone regions in North America and Central Asia as part of a shifting climate zones, erosion of the West Antarctic ice sheet with a consequent worldwide rise in sea level, and the opening of the fabled Northwest Passage. 31 years later, drought-prone regions are receiving less rainfall. The Antarctic ice has begun to crack and crumble. Bowhead whales are using the Northwest Passage as a polar shortcut. Scientists wrote, in light of historical evidence, in light of historical evidence that it takes several decades to complete a major change in fuel use, this makes large climate change almost inevitable. Hansen wrote in 1981. He wrote in anticipation of the difficulties of a global shift away from dependence on carbon dioxide emitting fossil fuels, writing, quote, CO2 effects on climate may make full exploitation of coal resources undesirable. An appropriate strategy may be to encourage energy conservation and develop alternative energy sources while using fossil fuels as necessary during the next few decades. Well, those next few decades have passed. And as he was writing that, Ronald Reagan was pulling down the solar panels from the roof of the White House. So there's your where-effed moment of the day.